Hello friends, now I am going to speak about sterilization techniques involved in plant tissue culture. So basically, what actually sterilization is? Sterilization is a process where we are eliminating the unwanted microbes which are interfering in the process of plant tissue culture. We are inoculating many explants, so some of the microbes can interfere in that experiment and they can degrade the nutrient media so that the explant cannot grow into a callus. Actually, sterilization is a process where we are freeing the glass equipments or the media from the unwanted microbes which are interfering in our experiment. So there are many types in sterilization. There are some of the chemical sterilants and even some of the physical methods for sterilization. So first of all, I would like to tell about chemical sterilants. So the chemical sterilants which we are using will be 70% alcohol or even 0.8% or 0.8% mercury chloride, etc. Many of the chemical sterilants can be used for sterilization purpose. The glass equipments or the explants, if we consider leaf as our explant, the leaf can be surface sterilized by dipping the leaf in 0.8% mercury chloride or even in 70% alcohol. So for example purpose, I am just taking two chemicals as chemical sterilants. There are many other chemical sterilants like Twin 20, SDS and some other detergents. When we dip the leaf or any explant in these chemical sterilants, the chemical sterilants will degrade the protein of microbes and it will look after that the microbes will not regain its activity and it will be killed so that the leaf gets sterilized. In the same way, there are some physical methods. First of all, let's consider heat sterilization. In heat sterilization, there are two types. One is dry heat sterilization and another one is moist heat sterilization. We can use instruments like autoclave and hot air oven for sterilization purpose. Autoclave is used for moist heat sterilization and hot air oven can be used for dry heat sterilization. In moist heat sterilization, the steam is produced by boiling the water, same as the principle involved in cooker. Autoclave produces steam which will be having the temperature of 121 degrees Celsius and 15 psi pressure. In this temperature, the water droplets or steam produced will be having high penetration power so that it will penetrate into the glass equipments which is to be sterilized and it will degrade the proteins of microbes and hence we can get a sterilized glass equipments. We can use those equipments for our experiments. In the same way, hot air oven is used for dry heat sterilization. In dry heat sterilization, the temperature will be at around 180 degrees Celsius. The 80 degrees Celsius temperature should be maintained for 2 to 3 hours. In case of these two sterilization techniques, we can consider moist heat sterilization as one of the best and efficient method of sterilization because in moist heat sterilization, the microbes cannot regain its activity. There will be some of the thermophiles which can regain its activity when the temperature reduces, or even the thermophiles are resistant to high temperature. When those bacteria or microbes are subjected to high temperature, they can regain their activity. In case of moist sterilization, when the microbes are exposed to hot steam, once the proteins get degraded, the microbes cannot regain its activity. And even in case of duration, moist sterilization is carried on only for 20 minutes, but the dry heat sterilization is carried on for 2 to 3 hours. We can save the time by following moist heat sterilization technique. The instrument used for moist heat sterilization technique is autoclave. See, another experiment or another sterilization technique which we can follow is in tissue culture, in plant tissue culture, there is a need of sterilizing the room space or the room where we work or room where we inoculate. There are two rooms in plant tissue culture. One is for incubation and another one is for inoculation. So these two rooms should be sterilized. The room space of these two rooms should be sterilized using some of the chemical vapors. The most preferable chemical used for this purpose can be formaldehyde. When you take around 20 to 40 ml of formaldehyde and If we add a pinch of potassium permanganate in it, it will produce some vapors. And when we keep that beaker containing this solution for 24 hours in particular room, and when we seal the opening of that particular room using a gum tape, the vapors will degrade the proteins of the microbes which will present in that particular area, and it will look after that. The room which is used for inoculation and incubation is sterilized. So these are some of the techniques where we can sterilize the glass equipments or even the room space provided. In the same way, we can use some of the filter papers for sterilizing the media. In some cases, the media, it may be heat liable, it may be susceptible to the heat, or it may be sensitive to the heat. In case of this, in this case, we can sterilize the media by filtration. Filtration is a process where the filter paper will be having minute pores lesser than the size of microbial cells. When we pass or when we filter the media by using these kind of filter papers, the media will get sterilized without exposing to or without getting exposed to heat. So this is one of the technique where we can use some filter papers through which we can sterilize the media when we use some of the volatile compounds. In the same way, radiations can be used for sterilization. Some of the radiations like UV light, gamma, X-rays can also be used for sterilization. We have a chamber called as, we have an instrument called as laminar airflow chamber, where the laminar airflow chamber will provide an aseptic condition which will be provided with UV light and also a blower. So this instrument will provide aseptic condition for our work. The inoculation procedure should be carried on inside the LIF chamber. First of all, the LIF chamber should be wiped with the chemical sterilant, and then the UV light source should be switched on so that those radiation which is produced from the source, it will kill the bacteria or it will kill the microbes present inside the chamber by causing mutation or by causing mutation in the microbial cell. In this way, we can provide an aseptic condition, or else we can carry on our experiments in an aseptic condition or aseptic manner. In plant tissue culture, it is much needed that the experiment should be away from all the unwanted microbes. If the microbes once interfere in our experiment, it will degrade the media or it will degrade the nutrient composition of the media, so that the necessary nutrient composition is not available for the explant to grow as a callus. So sterilization techniques should be followed in a very proper manner so that the microbes are eliminated and we can carry on our experiments in a well aseptic manner. So these microbes should be hindered, or the microbes may hinder the production of callus or division of the cell. Hence, the fungal spores or bacterial spores should be exposed to some of these sterilants, where we can eliminate all the microbes and then we can carry our tissue culture work in an aseptic condition. Maintenance of aseptic condition in case of tissue culture is very much needed. It is very important to get proper results, to get the proper results and to observe the growth of callus. We should and we must avoid the growth of microbes inside the media. Thank you.